Sorry guys, I did lose the footage for the beginning of this video, but it doesn't really matter anyways because it was just an intro and I only caught like two smallmouth. So yeah, so I'm just gonna get straight into the video.
What's up guys, bait and tackle fishing here out on a nice lake, Lake Meyer. It's not too far from anywhere. It's got campgrounds up there and there's northern pike, largemouth, crappie, bluegill, perch. Hopefully we can get a perch for the tank like I said in the last video. So I just got on this I don't know what it's called, but it's basically an inline spinner with the spinner below the center of gravity, so it spins more like the, I guess you'd call it the tail. It'll spin the water and it has an erratic motion. So it's good for pike and largemouth. So let's catch some fish. Dad just got a bass, as you can see. It's not too bad. Been trolling for 30 minutes maybe. I don't know. Been out here, got out here early in the morning, and had a catfish on that he snagged and snapped me off. So, and that reel on that pole's not too good anyway. But we're just gonna roll around the bank, see if we can catch it, get it down. Catch a fish. My friend just caught his first pike ever. Yo, bro. Oh. Yeah. Oh. Maybe tiny, but they still fight hard, dude. What do you think he had on when he hooked him? Yeah, he hit pretty hard. I thought he had like a 9-pound smallmouth on. Yeah, the entire thing was inside of his mouth. String was all frayed and everything. Shove your finger down his gill. You got a nice pike there. Yep, sure hold on. Got another fish on, guys. I've just got state record stick bass. This thing is at least 10 pounds. Biggest one I've ever seen in Iowa. Oh my god, I got a fish on. And my other one. Show you what the water looks like. Get some underwater footage. Oh, I got a fish. Oh, nice rock bass. He choked that. I'm gonna have to use my scissors, but a nice rock bass. I'm gonna have to get him off and put him back in the water. Hey guys, I just figured out what was wrong with my camera view. Anyways. So, when fishing for crappie and rock bass, they like protection, and they will not hit anything unless they're in their comfort zone. Ooh, that was a bad cast. caster off in front, let it drift in front of all the crevices and trees, and if you're lucky, you'll get something. I'm only using a little chunk of worm, so I'm letting it drift behind the pier, and once, like, the line gets caught, as you can see, it'll get caught on, like, this side, and it'll pull that worm up against the wall, and that, like I said before, that's where the fish will be, so. Every time I've casted it out there, I've gotten a fish. Someone's nibbling on it. Oh, there we go. Oh, it came out. Intricate this tree is woven into this cement. It's like all up in the stuff. You get a snag and most likely not coming out. One time when I was fishing here, I pulled up like a 5-pound weight that you got cranked at. And I have no clue how I brought it up or what's it doing down here because, oh, yep, there we go. Another nice little rock bass. I'm gonna get him off and put him back in the water. Bad you eat this. Well, not too bad. Alright. Back to the beginning. Gonna get our little cast out. Guys, just got the fish in the tank. Do an underwater shot. Let's see, where's the mic at? The first day we put them in, Mr. Crab's back here. Another shot of him. Crawdad, so we tried eating them as soon as we put them in, so you must like it in here. Other fish seem to be happy after we lost all the other fish to a disease, which we don't know if it was a parasite or not, but he seemed to pull through perfectly. Has no more of those, like, looked like leeches at first, but they seemed to fall off, and we found out that they were clams, baby clams, because the crawdad has the same thing, but hope you like the video. Subscribe, comment what we should name the fish. He must be careful. He's just flying all over the place. Oh, not only that, but if I can find a couple, like right here, I got a minnow trap out and I put snails in here, little snails, so they can eat all the algae and stuff. And they've been doing a good job. But the watermark shows how they've gone across the top and ate it all off. But anyways, I'll see you in the next video.